Now, question number 14. So it's given that MN is parallel to BC in this triangle, and AN is 4 and NC is 5. So I can say AC is equal to 9. That is, then the ratio 4 is to 5. So I'm just taking it as 4 and 5. Okay, nothing wrong with that. And AC, I'm taking it as 9. Okay, or you can take just 4x, 5x and 9x, you can say, right? So nothing, I mean, whichever way you want, you can take it. So now, because, you know, like MN is parallel to BC, you can say triangle ABC and MAN are similar triangles. Okay, ABC, that's the bigger triangle. Okay, and MAN, these are similar triangles. So which means area of MAN by area of ABC. Okay, you can write the ratio is 4 square by n square. Okay, I'm just using the proportionality theorem. So what is 4? AN value. Okay, so we are considering this triangle AMN, so MAN, so that's the AN value, and this is the 9 is AC value. Okay, so 4 square by 9 square. So the ratio is 16 by 81. So the ratio of the triangle MAN and ABC is 16 is to 81. Okay, now what is given here? The quadrilateral. Okay, so the bigger triangle, if it is, that's 81, and the smaller triangle is this triangle is 16, the bigger whole triangle is 81, and this quadrilateral, what is this quadrilateral? Now that's whatever is the area of triangle ABC minus triangle MAN. Okay, now that's the area of quadrilateral MBCN, right? So 81x minus 16x is equal to, this is 130, that is 65x is equal to 130. Okay, so x is equal to 60, I'm sorry, x equal to 2, which means area of this MAN is 16x, right? So if x is 2, 16x is, that is 32 square centimeter. Okay, so the whole triangle ABC is 162 centimeter square, and this particular triangle, the area is 32 square centimeter. So that's answer for question number 14. Now let's move to question number 15. Now question number 15, a trigonometry based question. So first we have that 6 tan A equal to 5. So I can write from this, I can write tan A is equal to 5 by 6. Okay, and we have also got that 8 sin A minus cos 4 cos A divided by cos A plus 2 sin A. Now this I can write it as, if I take cos A outside, right, now this will be 8 tan A minus 4, and in the denominator, if I take cos A common outside, that would be 1 plus 2 tan A. So that will be equal to cos A, anyhow is common, that will get cancelled. So you will have 8 tan A minus 4 by 1 plus 2 tan A. Right. Now, what we have got, tan A, we have got 5 by 6. Now, if I substitute that here, so 8 into 5 by 6 minus 4 by 1 plus 2 into tan A is 5 by 6. Right, so that would be 20 by 3 minus 4 by 1 plus 5 by 3. So that will be like finally 8 by 3 by 5 by 3. I'm sorry, 1 plus 5 by 3, right? So that is also 8 by 3. So 8 by 3 by 8 by 3, that's equal to 1. Answer is, answer choice 4 for question number 15. 1 is the answer. Okay, so I just missed that in the denominator, 1 plus 5 by 3. So that's 8 by 3. Okay, 8 by 3 by 8 by 3, answer is 1 for question number 15. Now question number 16. A shopkeeper marks a price. Now for this question also, you need to refer to that. If you are not already familiar with the percentage concept, you need to refer to that percentage video that I was mentioning earlier. So what is happening here? You are offering a discount of 28%. So after getting a discount of 20% discount, you can rate it as 0.8. So 28% discount, you can rate it as 0.72. So a 0.72 discount on mark price. Now you are making a gain of 12%. So 12%, we know we can rate it as 1.12 on cost price. So profit is always on the cost price only, right? And the mark price is given as 224. So 0.72 into 224 is equal to 1.12 by CP. Now decimal points, like two decimal points, right? So 0.72 and 112, right? So you can write it as 72 into 224 is equal to 112. Okay, now 0.12 here, 0.72 here. So I'm just removing the common decimal, right? So 122, 224 is twice. So cost price is equal to 72 into 2. That's 144. That's answer option 3. Now, whatever else you try, it's going to be very lengthy. So please stick on to this method for this question. Answer option 3, 144 is the answer. Now, question number 17. So you're given x and y and you're asked for x square plus y square. So this is x. So this square you have to do. This square. So it's basically like a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. So a plus b whole square, we know a square plus b square plus 2ab. A minus b whole square, we know a square plus b square minus 2ab. So this part, if you have to expand and write, it is 16 cos square a plus 25 sine square a plus 40 cos a sine a. Now, if you're confident, even without writing these steps, you can directly get. So, the next would be 16 sin square a plus 25 cos square a minus 40 cos a sin a. Cos a sin a. Now, this and this will get cancelled. So, you'll be left with. So, we know cos square a plus sin square a is 1. So 16 cos square a plus 16 sin square a would be 16, and 25 sin square a plus 25 cos square a would be 25. So 16 plus 25 would be 41. That's answer option 4 for question number 17. Now question number 18. So we get that x, y, z are three integers, and it's given that x plus y equal to 8, y plus z equal to 13, and z plus x equal to 17. Now, what we want is x square by yz is what is required. Now, let's just try to find the individual x, y, z. Now, if you add all this, what you get is twice x plus y plus z. Now, that would be 38. So, which means x plus y plus z is equal to 19. Now, if you know that x plus y plus z equal to 19, if you substitute this here, you will get z as 11. Similarly, if you substitute in this equation, you will get x is equal to 6. Here, if you substitute it here, you will get y equal to 2. Right. Now, what we want is x square by yz. Okay. Now, x square is 6 square. So, 6 into 6. Y is 2. Z is 11. So, this is 3. 18 by 11. That's answer option 2. Answer option 2 for question number 18. Answer option 3. We are supposed to find a cube minus b cube. We have a minus b and a into b we have. So a cube minus b cube formula, we know we can write it as a minus b whole cube plus 3x. Now this is the formula. Okay, a minus b whole cube plus 3ab into a minus b is the formula, right? So now if you substitute this here, So we'll get 4 cube, x minus y, it's given 4 cube plus 3xy. So that's 3 into 45, right? And x minus y, it's 4. Okay. So we get 4 cube plus 135, 540. Okay. So 64 plus 540, that's 604. Okay, that's answer option one. But the alternate, you know, like way I would, you know, like suggest is, let's say you are someone like me, right? So you can't remember something like this a plus b whole cube, or, you know, like a cube minus b cube, such kind of formulas, let's say you can't remember. Okay, so you can, from the given values, you can try to guess the values for x and y. Okay, so x into y is 45. What are the possibilities? 1 into 45. Okay, 3 into 15, 5 into 9. These are the only three possibilities. So either it can be 1 into 15 or the 3 into, I'm sorry, 1 into 45 or 3 into 15 or 5 into 9. Nothing else is possible, right? And among this, which one can give you x minus y equal to 4? Only 9 and 5. So 9 into 5 is 45. 9 minus 4 is, I'm sorry, 9 into 5 is 45. So the second part is satisfied. And 9 minus 5 is 4. So the first part is satisfied. So the value for x and y is 9, 5. Now this you substitute here, x cube and y cube. So what is x cube? 9 cube. 9 cube minus 5 cube is 125. 5 cube. I mean, 9 cube is 729 and 5 cube. So 729 minus 125, that's 604. So I prefer the second method. It's up to you to follow whatever method you want. But this is one of the good options. So question number 19, answer is answer option 1, 604. Question number 20, a person is selling an article at 10% below the cost price. Had he sold it for 332 more, he would have got a profit of 20%. That is, selling at a 10% loss. Okay. Now, what is the first SP1 is selling at a 10% loss. That's 0.9 of cost price. Now, what is SP2? Selling price of a 20% profit. So, 1.2. Right. So, what is the rise here? It is a 30% increase. Okay. It's a 30% increase. Now, that 30% increase, okay, that so 30% of cost price. Now that's equal to 332 rupees. The 30% of cost price is 332 rupees. Now what is asked here is very simple. They've asked for the original selling price. If they ask for cost price, it's a little more calculation, but they've asked for, okay, so original selling price is 90% of 10% loss, right? So there is 90% of the cost price. So if 30% of cost price is 332, 90% or 0.9 of cost price is just 3 times this. 3 times 30 is 90. Okay. So 3 times 332 is 996. That's all. That's the answer. 996 is the answer for question number 20. Now question number 21. So here, wherever you have plus, you have to put minus, and wherever you have minus, you have to put plus, and wherever you find multiplication, you have to put division, and wherever you find division, you have to put multiplication. So let's start writing. So 42 minus 12, so it is plus 12 divided by 3 minus 8 into 2 minus 15. That's the numerator, and in the denominator, 8 divided by 2. Plus 4 minus 9 into 3. So when you want to calculate, so this 12 divided by 3 first and then 8 into 2 next. Here it is 8 divided by 2 first and then like 9 into 3 and so on. So within the bracket. So let's start solving it. So 42 plus 12 divided by 3 is 4 minus 16 minus 15 by 8 divided by 2 is 4 plus 4 minus 9 into 3 is 27. So here we have 46 minus 31 by 8 minus 27. that's equal to 15 by 19. Of course, minus 19. So minus 15 by 19, that's answer option 3 for question number 21. Answer option 3, minus 15 by 19. Question number 22, it's a very simple question. So if the number 105x4 is completely divisible by 8, then what is the smallest integer in place of 8? So we know the divisibility test for 8, the last 3 digits should be divisible by 8. If the last 3 digits is divisible by 8, then the number itself is divisible by 8. So the divisibility test for 2 is what? You're looking at the unit digit. Okay, the last digit, if it is divisible by 2, I mean, if it is an even number, then it's divisible by 2. For 4, if the last 2 digits, if it is divisible by 4, then the number itself is divisible. Or if there are 2 zeros also, that's fine. Okay. Similarly, for 8, the last 3 digits should be divisible by 8, then the number itself is divisible. Or if the last 3 numbers are 0, then that's also fine. So here, now just, you know, like we can take it from the option and try to substitute it. The last 3 digits should be divisible. First option is substitute, that itself is divisible. So 504 by 8, it is exactly divisible. The remainder is 0. So the answer is answer option 1, 0. Now if you substitute 4, 544 is possible. But what is asked is the smallest integer. Okay, so 504 is divisible by 8. 544 is also divisible by 8. Okay. Right. Though 524 or 514 is not divisible. So 2 and 1 is not possible, but 0 and 4 is possible. X can take 0, X can take 4. It will be divisible by 8. But they're asking for the smallest integer. So the answer is answer option 1. 504 is exactly divisible by 8. So the number itself is divisible. That is 100504. Okay. So that is 1,504 is divisible by 8. Okay. So you just have to check only the last 3 digits. That's the divisibility test for 8. It's a very simple and a direct question. Question number 23. If 4,300 becomes 4,644 in 2 years in simple interest, find the principal amount that will become 10,104 in 5 years at the same rate of interest. So what is happening here? Principal plus the rate of the interest rate, right? So that is P into how many years? 2 years. Rate of interest, we don't know. Okay, that is what we have to find. Now that is equal to 4,644. Okay. So if you take this P the other side, you will have 4,300 into 2 into R by 100 is equal to this P. If it is goes to this side, it will be like minus 4,300, right? So that will be 344. Okay. Now 2, this is like 172. This is 172, 43. So R is equal to 4%. Rate of interest is 4%. Right. Now the next question is, for in 5 years, if an amount is becoming 10,104, what is the principal? Okay. Now let's do this again. Now principal plus principal into, you have found the rate of interest is 4% for 5 years. Okay, now that is equal to this 10,104. Okay, now you can take P common out, 1 plus 20 by, I mean, now we can just simplify this. Okay, 5, right? So P into 6 by 5 is 10104. So we can write principal is equal to 10104 into 5 by 6. Into 5 by 6. So the 6, it is 16 times 40, you have 50, you have like 8 times, and then 24, you have 4 times, 1684 into 5, 8420, 84, 2-0. That's answer option 1 for this question. Okay. So first, you're getting the rate of interest. That's 4%. Now that, then again, you're substituting in the second equation, and then you're getting the value for the principal, 8420. Now question number 24. A, B and C are 3 points on a circle such that the angle subtended by the chord AB and AC at the center O are 110 and 130 respectively. Then what is the value of angle BAC? Okay, so the diagram can be like this. So we have ABC are 3 points on a circle. Okay, and then you have the chord AB and AC. Okay, and so angle are like 110 and 130 respectively. Now what is the value of angle BAC? Now please remember OA, OC and OB are the radius, which means these three are equal. Okay, so OA, OB and OC are equal. Now what we want is angle BAC. Okay, now this angle is what we want. Okay, so let us take this part as X. Okay, that is CAO as X and OAB as Y. So what we want is X plus Y. Right. Now, as I said before, OB, OA and OC are the radius, which means in the triangle, take the triangle OAC. Take the triangle OAC. Now, if this angle is 130, now since OC and OA are radius, the two sides are equal, which means the other two angles are also equal. So if this is X, then this is also X. Similarly, if you take the other triangle OAC, OAB, right, now this angle is 110, and if this angle and OB and OA are radius to the circle. So if this angle is Y, then this is also Y, right? So which means that now total is 180. Now if this angle is 110, the remaining must be 70, so which is 35 and 35. So yeah, so Y is 35. Similarly, other side, if you take the total angle, other triangle, if you take 180, right? So this X and X total, the remaining is 50. So this X should be 25 and the other, another X, right? So that is also 25. So 25 plus 35, the angle, okay, at BAC is 60 degree. That's answer option 3 for question number 24. Now, question number 25, a time and work question. So ABC can individually complete a piece of work in 24 days, 15 days and 12 days respectively. If B and C start working together, they and they work for 2 or 3 days and left, then A alone will complete the task in how many days? It's a very simple question. So first B and C work. Now 1 day work of, now B can complete the task in 15 days. So 1 day work of B is 1 by 15. C can complete the task in 12 days. So 1 day work of C is 1 by 12. And together they work for 3 days. Right. So this is 3 into LCM is 60. So this is like 4 and 5. So 9 by 60. So this is like you can write 27 by 60, or you can write 9 by, you can just simplify and write 9 by 20. Right. Now A will complete the remaining task in how many days? Now A will do the full task in 24 days. Right. Now how much task is over? Now B and C together, they have completed 9 by 20th of the task. How much task is left out? 11 by 20th of the task is left out. Okay. If 9 by 20 is over, 11 by 20 is left out. This 11. Now, full work A will do in 24 days, 11 by 20th of the task, A will do in 11 by 20 into 24. So, this is like 6, this is 5. So, you have 66 by 5, which is 13, 1 by 5. That's answer option 1 for question number 25. Right. So, we have come to the end. I hope you liked my methods in this video, and this video was useful to you, I guess. If you have any questions, please do post your questions in the comment section below. For more videos on job alerts, aptitude, reasoning and general awareness, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching the video. Have a great day.